Hello, adventure riders from around the world. You may have been expecting to see Pavlen telling you all about adventure bikes, but he's a little bit busy right now. Oh, hang on, I think here he comes. What's he riding? He's riding a Zero with a top box. Smells like brakes. Those brakes smell hot.
What are you doing?
I'm taking over your channel.
Without my permission?
Nah, no worries. You're a good man. You're a good man. I can afford and I can risk my channel because of you. All right. So, hello to everyone. So, the reason I'm riding this motorcycle is first because I've got this chance. And the second reason is because I promised you so many interesting things. And again, I plan to surprise you, and I'm sure that I already surprised you thanks to my cameraman Andy. So we're gonna make a detailed video review of Zero DS. So as you know, I already made one video review of the Zero XF, I believe it was sport version, but this is a little bit different. And the idea of this review is to show you that this bike is capable even for touring or commuting or whatever you decide to use it. Of course, we're gonna talk about everything. So first I will give you some specs, and of course after that I will let Andy to talk about it, because he has a long term experience with the bike, and he will tell you everything, the pros and the cons of owning of this type of bikes. And but just to let you know, he explained me about it and showed me a couple of videos about guys who actually traveling, sorry about the noise, but we are on the very busy crossroad here, not crossroad like this, turns. And he actually interviewed and I've got the videos of a couple of people who actually riding this bike, a lady riding from Belgium to Istanbul, or another guy who rode from Germany to Iceland. So I will link all of their details in the description down below, just to see that yes, these bikes are possible, they are good, you can travel, but of course with some limitations. So as you can see, this is 11.4 kilowatts. It's a different power. It's not like the one I tested. The one I tested was 8.5 or something similar. But what I noticed, it's a few differences. If I compare with the conventional motorcycles like his Yamaha Tenere or any bike with just petrol engine and gears and shit, I experienced some difficulties to learn it properly, to ride it properly, because the lack of clutch, the lack of gear actually make me in some, how I have to say, not so secure modes. I cannot really control the bike properly, because when I don't have the clutch, when I don't have the gears, I have to rely only on the stopping power of the brakes. And which is not so good when I have rolls like this, these twisty rolls, so I have to slow down. And as I said, I have to rely only on the brakes, which is not what I usually do. What I usually do, I just put a gear down and use the engine brake power to slow down and control the bike. And another thing I experienced, because the bike has so heavy front part because of the battery. You see, this, all of these are the batteries here, the engine, and the front wheel is 19 inch. I feel it so heavy on the front. Actually, the feeling to ride this motorcycle is very similar as you ride when you ride sport motorcycles. And I stopped riding sport motorcycles many years ago, and now for me it's something new. And it's neat practice, but once you learn it, man, it's like a blast. It's a real pleasure to ride it, because you hear nothing, but you've got this instant power immediately, all of this, whatever equivalent of horsepower it has. Yeah, now what we're gonna do now, I'm gonna switch the position with Andy and we'll let him talk about the bikes, because he will give you a lot of insight, a lot of specs of the machine. And I believe that this information could be very useful for each and every one of you who ever planned to buy this bike for commuting, traveling, or for whatever purpose you decide to buy. Okay, let's switch the mics. And just a second, yeah.
I'm back to take over the channel.
Yeah, take it. You have my permission.
That's good. You don't want me on your channel. All right, so I've been riding this Zero for 3 years. I got 45,000 kilometers on it. I'll give you the good points, right? Power, really good. The drivetrain, so for example, the motor, the controller, Really, really good, right? So you've got a ZF motor. It's quite a powerful motor, and you've got a controller that's in here, which is really good. The it also takes a lot of luggage. So I have, on this one, I've got the Givi racks. Of course, I have the top box just for Pavlen. I just fitted it today. And it's got
don't laugh.
It's got a lot of plus points. Okay, the bad points. Right. First of all, you can travel far on it, but you do have to charge it. So you got to think of this bike as being like having a very small petrol tank. So even though it performs like a regular bike, it might only go say 80 kilometers or 90 kilometers before you have to fill up the tank, right? It can take a long time to charge if you use the onboard charger, but you can also put external chargers on it so that it will actually charge faster. Yeah. The other bad points, I guess, is we don't know how long these batteries are going to last. Like, that's one of the issues. Pavlen and myself were talking. It's like, there's 45,000 kilometers on this bike now, and whether it will do 100,000, 200,000, there's no real evidence to say that it's going to do, say, 200,000 kilometers. Right now, it's got 45,000. Yeah? Is it 45, isn't it? So, look, I can't really fault the bike. I was using it as a commuting bike and some tours. You can check out my YouTube channel to the EV motorcycle is the YouTube channel, to have a look at what we've been doing with the electric bikes. It's still
Sorry for the interruption. Guys, in the last 2 days, I learned so much from him. Honestly. I learned so much from him because what he actually do for a living is video editing.
Yeah.
I always consider myself like a normal, not exactly skilled, but I believe that I've got some skills. When I checked his studio and the way he do all the things, man, for 2 days, I got so much information, the information I couldn't get in the last 10 years. Continue.
But the most important piece of information is that the top box is really important to use on the motorbike.
I'm not hearing you.
So what do I say to summarize? Look, Zero is a really good bike. Maybe in 5 years' time, there are new models, but maybe in 5 years' time, we will get some really good traction with different manufacturers. Zero's kind of, you've got Energica as well. There's a few brands out there, but it's still in its infancy. I think that in 10 years' time, a lot more people will be riding these bikes. Also, there are a lot of adventure riders who have been doing big adventures, like Electro Girl, what we mentioned, and also Uwe Ryman, who's done around Iceland. It's brilliant, brilliant riding. And I have videos that I'm going to put up with relation to those once they get edited. But other than that, it's a good bike. I'd recommend it. But for big tours, it's still not going to be the best.
Let me ask you a few questions. I'll come closer because of the
mic.
I don't want to kiss you, but I need the mic. Yeah. So just a few questions. First is reliability. Okay, you're going to talk
no
about
problem.
It. Okay, second question is handling. Did you have any issues to learn how to use this bike? Exactly what I said at the beginning.
Yeah, I think reliability has been excellent. Okay. Like, I haven't had any problems with this bike. In 45,000 kilometers, it's been excellent, right? Handling, it is like a sports bike. One of the things that I find, I keep like a road tire on it, but it's a road trail, but the reality is that it's more of a road tire than a trail. So these are Pirelli Scorpion Trails. The Scorpion Trail 2, I believe. And I have an Aniki, Michelin Aniki 3 on the back. Now, this back tire, believe it or not, this is 45,000 kilometers on this back tire. It's nearly ready to be replaced, but there's very little wear on this tire. On the front tire, that's the third tire on the front. So Pavlen is correct. Because it's heavy on the front, you're constantly braking all the time. So brake, brake, brake. So what you're getting is you're getting all this load on the front tire. So it's burning out the front tire. The other bad points about the bike is the brakes and the suspension. Look, it will carry luggage. I wouldn't carry a passenger on it for any long period of time. It will carry luggage like top box and panniers, but the suspension on this version isn't great. The suspension on the newer version is better. There is an SRF version that they have released as well, which has proper Brembo brakes. I don't know if they're Brembo, but they're equivalent Brembo brakes and they're high quality. But this one is okay from a brakes perspective. It'll stop you, but you won't be doing stoppies on it. What do you reckon, Pavlen? So what do you think, Pavlen? You've had a ride of this bike. So what do you think about it?
Well, what is the biggest issue at the moment is how fast you can charge it. Tell me more about how you do it and all of this free pace you've got. Yeah.
Well, a real life scenario is that I ride to work. So if I ride 80 kilometers and I leave the bike for 4 hours just on a regular plug socket, it will charge easily in that time. But if I want to go faster, for example, if I wanted to ride and then charge it as fast as possible, then ride again, I can do that in 45 minutes using three phase or using different electric vehicle charging options. The problem is that you have to carry the charger. So as well as the top box, you're also going to be carrying extra chargers for it. So the weight becomes a problem. And as you say, Pavlen, the weight always matters. And as you start adding more and more weight to the bike, it reduces the performance of the bike because it doesn't go as far. It becomes less aerodynamic and so on, you know?
So tell me a little bit more about your real experience for this commuting. Why you decided that you might switch again after, let's say, 5 years? Yeah.
So I've been riding this bike for 3 years to and from work for commuting. But I live very far away from work. So I live like 80 kilometers away from work. And what I find is that sometimes I have to manage my power consumption as I'm riding it. And it means that I have to go slower. And most of my riding is on the freeway. And the problem with riding on the freeway is that, especially in Australia, you will get a lot of people driving over you. So you really need to have the power to be, it has the power, but you really need to be able to have the consistent power to be able to go at 100, 110 kilometers for 70 kilometers. And yes, you can do it sometimes, like in certain conditions, but mostly on this bike, if I had 3 kilowatt hours more, that would be perfect. But for me, for my application, it's not the perfect solution. But if I was living 50 kilometers away from work, it would be absolutely perfect if I could charge at work. I would not sell this, I would keep this forever if I could do that.
And just to point you again, to remind about this free phase you've got in your garage.
Yeah, I got three phase. So there's an app called PlugShare, and the PlugShare app allows you to put your charging options onto a website. So I have three phase in my house. So if I really need to charge really quickly, I can charge within 45 minutes on that.
What is the normal time?
So if it's from zero, which is never from zero, but I'd say the normal time is around 4 hours. Right. But you have to then manage your time, right? So if you're on a big tour, you know, you want to do 300 kilometers, 400 kilometers, and you have to manage the amount of charges that are in there. So it's not ready yet for big touring. Some people have done it, but it is definitely a commuter option, 100%.
If you have one piece of advice for everyone who ever planned to buy it or think about it, what will be?
Just have to manage, just watch your expectations with this technology right now. The expectation is that if you read on the Zero website, for example, they say, oh, it will do 200 kilometers. You have to make sure that it will actually do 200 kilometers realistically, because it is different types of riding. One thing that I will say about owning an electric motorcycle is that you become very aware of how much energy is actually used. So I could tell you that it takes 5 kilowatts to go from here into the city, and you can manage your energy very well. But I think that if you think that you're going to buy an electric bike and then ride for 300 kilometers and it's easy, it's not like that. Yes.
So what basically is the easiest way? 1 kilowatt is like one.
It's like a liter of fuel.
Like a liter of fuel.
Yeah, yeah.
You can calculate this way.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. So we have now 11.4, which is mean you can go 112 or something like.
Yeah, kilometers. Yeah.
Kilometers. All right.
Yeah.
All right.
It's good.
Yeah. Okay. So I think this was very, very informative. So, as I said, guys, I will link all of his details in the description down below. If you have any questions, just ask him, because I really don't have the answers. And also, don't forget to check his stuff. I'm not bullshitting you. I've seen a lot of people in the last 10-15 years. He's really good and talented guy. Just check. I'm not pushing you to check his channel, but just go and see his work, because it's really, really worth it. And again, if you have questions, go and link it down below. Thank you very
now,
much, Andy.
I'm going to take Pavlen's channel over.
Yeah. No
Let's
worries.
Go.
No worries. All right. Don't forget to subscribe.
Yeah.
And see you next time.
Ciao. Bye-bye.